Instant drawing. That's all photography is. I began as a painter and that's all I hang from the walls of my apartment. Not a single photo. I spent 45 years behind a camera and all I can say about the subject is that it doesn't interest me. But first, a little bit about me. I was born on a hot summer day in August 22nd, 1908 at the Chanelieu Saint-Amani. I grew up to going to school near Paris and went off to the University of Cambridge in 1929. Before school in 1927, I studied paintings at André Lutz Academy in Montparnasse, from where I entered the world of avant-garde. My wife, Martine, always said that I knew just where to be at the right moment, destined for my photography. When I shoot, I use my 35mm camera, not only because it's small, because it is silent as well, so I could stay hidden unnoticed as I captured the perfect shot. I traveled around the world in search for my great photography. I found an Indian child who was starving to death with ribs looking like wagon wheels in the background, to Shanghai, where I found people in 1949 willing to sell their gold before Mao Zedong's revolution came over them. I mainly took pictures of people. Not just of people, but people doing everyday routines. From children playing in the streets of Paris, to a girl getting her hair done in Indonesia. I was drafted into the French army in 1940 when I was taken prisoner by the Germans and escaped on my third try after being captured. I assisted the work of a bonhomme show that I worked for and organized the Museum of Modern Art in New York. I founded the Mano Photo Agency in 1913. I spent the next 20 years of my life working on capturing upheavals in India, China, also Soviet Union, Cuba, Canada, Japan, and Mexico.